stay seated. This is the pre-service announcement. But a big warm welcome to you. Isn't it lovely to be back? I hope you think so. I can't say, for me it's not bad, for me it's the first time. So I'm really, really delighted to see you and delighted to be with you. And we'll be joined this morning by Jean Robinson, who will be the celebrant this morning. We are lucky with a marvellous team here, and I know how grateful I am and you are for all the work that they've done over the past year, especially. There are, of course, a number of COVID-related restrictions, which I expect you're aware of, but I need to remind you of anyway. There's a full account of the restrictions and the various rules and procedures in the service sheet, at the beginning of the service sheet. But let me just remind you that during the service, please don't move out of your seats except when you are invited to do so by the stewards for taking a communion. No congregational singing is allowed, I'm afraid. But we will be hearing from the choir, and actually the guidance changed very last minute on Friday, so we've been able to respond to that with having quite a decent number in the choir this morning. And at the end, please do stay in your seats if you wish to, I hope you will, to hear the organ voluntary at the end, but otherwise I'm going to have to ask you to clear off. Because we can't mingle at all. It's a real shame. It'd be lovely to meet. I mean, I see some faces I know, mostly ones I've only really seen or met on Zoom. But anyway, so that's the opportunity. The rules are going to be restricted, a bit less restricted even as soon as next week, so we might be able to have a bit of a chance to chat at least outside after next week's service. Okay?
Would you please stand? Hosanna to the Son of David, the King of Israel. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Grace, mercy, and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, during Lent we have been preparing by works of love and self-sacrifice for the celebration of our Lord's death and resurrection. Today we come together to begin this solemn celebration in union with the Church throughout the world. Christ enters his own city to complete his work as our Saviour, to suffer, to die, and to rise again. Let us go with him in faith and love, so that, united with him in his sufferings, we may share his risen life. Ask God's blessing upon these hard crosses. God our Saviour, whose Son Jesus Christ entered Jerusalem as Messiah to suffer and to die, let these paths be for us signs of his victory, and grant we who bear them in his name may ever hail him as our King and follow him in the way that leads to eternal life. Who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
When they were approaching Jerusalem at Bethphage and Bethany near the Mount of Olives, he sent two of his disciples and said to them, "Go into the village ahead of you. And immediately as you enter it, you will find tied there a colt that has never been ridden. untie it and prune it. If anyone says to you, why are you doing this? Just say this, the Lord needs it and will send it back here immediately. They went away and found a colt tied near a door outside in the street. As they were untying it, some of the bystanders said to them, what are you doing untying the colt? They told them what Jesus had said, and they allowed them to take it. Then they brought the colt to Jesus and threw their cloaks on it, and he sat on it. Many people spread their cloaks on the road, and others spread leafy branches that they had cut in the fields. Then those who went ahead and those who followed were shouting, Hosanna! Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the coming kingdom of our ancestor David. Hosanna in the highest heaven. And he entered Jerusalem and went into the temple. And when he had looked around at everything, as it was already late, he went out to Bethany with the 12. This is the gospel of the Lord. One God, now and forever.
Amen.
Praise to you, O Christ, King of eternal glory. Christ humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even death on a cross. Therefore God has highly exalted him, and given him the name that is above every name. Praise to you, O Christ, King of eternal glory. The Passion of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Mark. As soon as it was morning, the chief priests held a consultation with the elders and scribes and the whole council. They bound Jesus, led him away, and handed him over to Pilate. Pilate asked him, "Are you the King of the Jews?" He answered him, "You say so." Then the chief priests accused him of many things. Pilate asked him again, "Have you no answer? See how many charges they bring against you." But Jesus made no further reply, so that Pilate was amazed. Now at the festival, he used to release a prisoner for them, anyone for whom they asked. Now a man called Barabbas was in prison with the rebels, who had committed murder during the insurrection. So the crowd came and began to ask Pilate to do for them according to his custom. Then he answered them, "Do you want me to release for you the King of the Jews?" For he realized that it was out of jealousy that the chief priests had handed him over. But the chief priests stirred up the crowd to have him release Barabbas for them instead. Pilate spoke to them again, "Then what do you wish me to do with the man you call the King of the Jews?" They shouted back, "Crucify him!" Pilate asked them, "Why? What evil has he done?" But they shouted all the more, "Crucify him!" So Pilate, wishing to satisfy the crowd, released Barabbas for them, and after flogging Jesus, he handed him over to be crucified. This is the Passion of the Lord. May I speak in the name of the living God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated. Palm Sunday is a day of contrasting moods, of paradoxes. We begin with the triumphal entry into Jerusalem, the crowds laying down their palm branches and proclaiming the arrival of the Son of David. But soon enough, we are telling the story of Jesus' passion, the events that culminate in his death, with the crowds now choosing Barabbas over Jesus. So what's going on? How come things turn around in such a short time? Well, there are one or two things that we need to understand about the context. Jerusalem was, as they say, a powder keg. The city was full for the Passover. Kind of imagine London during a major demonstration, because the background is all the time the desire of the Jews for political freedom. Ordinary Jews fill Jerusalem, whose dearest hope is the end of Roman rule and the restoration of the Jewish kingdom. The Roman governor, Pilate, is terrified precisely of that revolution, riot, and another and perhaps fatal black mark against his name. There have been other incidents, you see. And the Jewish religious leaders probably both want to protect their understanding of the Jewish faith, but their own status also as leaders in that faith. So there's a lot of political kind of stuff going on. Now, much is made of the humility of Jesus' arrival on a donkey. And indeed, that is so. But it should not obscure the fact that he also arrives as a king. And is acclaimed as one too. Hosanna to the Son of David. The Son of David is the king. Jesus is hailed quite explicitly here in Mark's Gospel as the man who will bring the kingdom. And Jesus does not reject any of this. And so there is no doubt that his arrival constitutes, shall we say, a major statement. And then, not much. Jesus continues to teach, but there's no move, no plot, no army, no revolution, no dramatic divine intervention. But all those whose interests lead them to suspect and fear Jesus, move against him and start to contrive his death. And, though we don't know if they're the same people, the crowds turn against him, preferring Barabbas, who, significantly enough, is an insurgent, a revolutionary. I said paradoxes at the beginning. Jesus comes as a king, but refuses to act to take earthly power. Many turn from him, because they are looking for real-world actions. Yet, he loses his life precisely because he is seen as a political threat. And he still comes to us this way, as a king, but not as one who seeks power over us and among us. He offers a vision of a kingdom, and by which I mean of a real change in the real world, but not in a way that supports hopes of violence or even identification with worldly political programs. And when Jesus does this, both then and now, he knows what he's doing. He knows how it's likely to end. And he lays down his own life for his vision of what God's kingdom looks like. Now he calls us, of course, to follow him, to model ourselves upon him. And he comes to us as he came to Jerusalem 2,000 years ago. How will we receive him this Holy Week and beyond? Amen. And now let us pray. For forgiveness for the many times we have denied Jesus, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For grace to seek out those habits of sin which mean spiritual death, and by prayer and self-discipline to overcome them. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For Christian people, that through the suffering of disunity, there may grow a rich union in Christ. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For those who make laws, interpret them and administer them, that our common life may be ordered in justice and mercy. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For those who still make Jerusalem a battleground, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For those who have the courage and honesty to work openly for justice and peace, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For those in the darkness and agony of isolation, that they may find support and encouragement, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For those who, weighed down with hardship, failure, or sorrow, feel that God is far from them, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For those who are tempted to give up the way of the cross, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. That we, with those who have died in faith, may find mercy in the day of Christ. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. Holy God, holy and strong, holy and immortal, have mercy upon us.
Once we were far off, but now in union with Christ Jesus, we have been brought near through the shedding of Christ's blood. For he is our peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Thank you.
Jesus, true vine and bread of life, ever giving yourself that the world might live, let us share your death and passion. Make us perfect in your love.
Amen.
The Lord is here.
His Spirit is with us.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
It is indeed right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. For as the time of his passion and resurrection draws near, the whole world is called to acknowledge his hidden majesty. The power of the life-giving cross reveals the judgment that has come upon the world and the triumph of Christ crucified. He is the victim who dies no more, the lamb once slain who lives forever, our advocate in heaven to plead our cause, exalting us there to join with angels and archangels forever praising you and saying, Holy,
holy,
holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna.
Wonderful the work of your hands, O Lord. As a mother tenderly gathers her children, you embrace the people as your own. When they turned away and rebelled, your love remained steadfast. From them you raised up Jesus, our Saviour, born of Mary, to be the living bread, in whom all our hungers are satisfied. He offered his life for sinners, with a love stronger than death. He opened wide his arms on the cross. And the night before he died, he came to supper with his friends, and taking bread, he gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to them, saying, Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. End of supper, taking a cup of wine, he gave you thanks and said, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. Great is the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
Father, we plead with confidence his sacrifice made once for all upon the cross. We remember his dying and rising in glory, and we rejoice that he intercedes for us at your right hand. Pour out your Holy Spirit as we bring before you these gifts of your creation. May they be for us the body and blood of your dear Son. As we eat and drink these holy things in your presence, form us in the likeness of Christ and build us into a living temple to your glory. Remember, Lord, your church in every land. Reveal her unity. Guard her faith and preserve her in peace. Bring us at the last with St. John, all the saints, to your vision of that eternal splendour for which you have created us. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom, with whom and in whom, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven, we worship you, Father Almighty, in songs of everlasting praise.
Blessing and honour and glory and power be yours forever and ever. Amen.
As our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father, hallowed be
your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, power, and glory are yours, now and forever.
Every time we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim
the Lord's death until he comes.
pray. Lord Jesus Christ, you humbled yourself in taking the form of a servant, and in obedience died on the cross for our salvation. Give us the mind to follow you and to proclaim you as Lord and King, to the glory of God the Father.
Amen. Amen.
Faithful Lord,
may we who share this sacrament glory in the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ, our salvation, life, and hope. Reign with us, Lord, now and forever.
I just have a couple of notices for you. The first is simply just to remind you what the form is for Holy Week this year. I mean, we are delighted that we're going to be able to be back in church, though of course things will be a little restricted in view of all the safety concerns. There will be an online Stations of the Cross, which Clive is going to be leading us through. That will be available on YouTube Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday this week. But on Thursday, Maundy Thursday, 8 p.m. Eucharist, we will be back in here, and I hope we'll see a good number of you then. There will be a watch afterwards for those of you who are able to stay for that. So that's Thursday at 8. Good Friday, there will be a simple service of reflection which Jean will be leading here at 2 p.m. Then on Easter Day, we will have a celebratory, as resurrection orientated, a celebration as we are able to have, given some of the restrictions that are around, and that will be at 10 o'clock. Now for that service, you will need a ticket, so if you haven't got your ticket, please do get your ticket organised by getting in touch with Vicky in the office. Now, I said at the beginning of the service that, you know, in the nicest possible way, once the organ voluntary is finished, I need you to clear off. However, that is not because we don't want to see you and we don't want to see each other, obviously. And there will be an opportunity at 11:45 to have a virtual get-together instead. We've been meeting using Zoom on Sundays at 11 for a few weeks now, and it's been really great to see the interaction, to be part of that interaction. And you are invited to, when you get home, dial in, that's not probably the right phrase anymore, but to join the Zoom call at 11:45 and have about half an hour of chat, bring a cup of coffee. If you're a bit intimidated by Zoom, don't be, it's not that difficult. And all the info is in the notice sheet. Thank you.
As you're able, would you please stand for God's blessing? May the Father, who so loved the world that he gave his only Son, bring you by faith to his eternal life.
Amen.
May Christ, who accepted the cup of sacrifice in obedience to the Father's will, keep you steadfast as you walk with him the way of his cross.
Amen.
May the Spirit, who strengthens us to suffer with Christ, that we may share his glory, set your minds on life and peace.
Amen.
And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ. Amen.